那么呢，接下来我们第一场国际交流专题演讲，我们邀请到 EcoCha 一口茶创办人 Andy 要为大家带来台湾有机茶在国际上的角色与定位。那么从1989年以来， Andy 呢，他大部分的时间都是住在台湾，开始学习而且爱上台湾在地的茶叶文化。因缘际会，1993年他到了鹿谷拜师学茶，持续探索茶世界。那对于台湾茶情有独钟，所以在1997年 Andy 就创立了一口茶品牌，开始外销商高品质的乌龙茶。那一口茶的宗旨呢，是要将企业永续经营的理念专门运用到台湾在地的特色茶产业，让台湾茶行销国际，让更多国际人士了解到如何品饮台湾茶这样子的美好。现在呢，就让我们一起热情掌声欢迎 Andy Kingcard。
Let me briefly introduce Andy Kingcard. Mr. Kingcard has lived mostly in Taiwan since 1989. In 1993, his appreciation for the local tea culture that he had already developed led him to the home of Tony Lin of Lu Gu Farmers Association. Since then, it has been an ongoing exploration of the world of tea, which has provided a fulfillment that is unique to Taiwan. Since 1997, Andy has been sharing this passion for tea as a private exporter of quality oolong tea. His company, EcoCha, is founded on the tenets of sustainable business practices as applied exclusively to the local specialty tea industry in Taiwan.
Thank you very much, Mr. Lee. Amazing interpreter. I just want to take this opportunity first to say thank you to Mr. Lee, the interpreter, who I believe is doing a wonderful job. Thank you.
这个我就不用翻了，他来谢谢我。
My name is Andy. As you already know, I'm very happy and honored to be here today to participate in this very important event, I believe. And just very exciting to see the organic tea industry starting to take off. So I was given this topic to talk about, Taiwan's organic tea and the global market.
Okay, so let me summarize.
Sure.
Sorry to interrupt.
No, please.
我简单讲哈，那么当然他就是 Andy， 他也听得懂中文，所以要很小心了哈。当然台湾的有机茶呢，在全世界慢慢展开来了，所以呢越来越有名了。那么 Andy 呢，也非常致力于推广我们的台湾有机茶。
So, in thinking about this topic and how to approach it, I basically just concluded that it's fairly simple. There are two sides of this dynamic, and the first is the source. Where does this wonderful product that we all love come from? So I'm going to talk about Taiwan's organic tea first. And the way that I did that was to approach tea farmers that both I already know and some that I hadn't met yet, and interviewed them with some basic questions, which were really just a reason, kind of setting the stage to go visit a lot of farmers and continue my exploration of this industry and learn more. So I prepared several basic questions. Mr. Lee, the first page will be in English, so we'll just allow the English-speaking people to take a look at these questions, and then the second page will be the questions in Chinese.
Chinese, okay. 那么刚刚他讲说要介绍这个台湾的有机茶的话，当然要讲到两大部分两个层面。第一个层面当然就是来源嘛，就是生产者、生产商。当然另外一个就是行销的部分。所以先讲生产者的部分。那么 Andy 呢，他非常的这一个热心，亲自拜访了台湾各地的这些茶农生产者。那么他会给我们一个清单，他所去拜访过的。第一页用英文，第二页用中文，所以等一下你看中文就知道。
Okay, so I'm just going to run through these questions quickly first, and then we'll look at them one by one later along with the answers. So the first one, when did you decide to go organic and why? What have been the biggest challenges you have faced since you went organic? Beyond the certification, how have you differentiated your brand and your products?What is the state of affairs for organic tea producers in Taiwan currently? And what is necessary for organic tea production to continue to develop in the future? And finally, what is your annual volume of produce and what type of teas, oolong tea, black tea, green tea, etc.?
OK， 那么这就是他的问卷哈。那么刚才英文版，现在是中文版的，我们来看一下。您 ，You want to read it?
No, please.
OK， 你们什么时候决定要做有机？动机是什么？当你开始做有机的时候，什么是你面对的最大挑战？撇除了认证，在市场上，你如何区隔你的品牌与产品？台湾有机茶生产者的境况处境为何？对有机茶生产的永续与未来的繁荣而言，什么是需要的作为？你一年出产的量多少？乌龙、红茶、绿茶，其他量是多少？
那我现在用这个机会谢谢张浩言，我已经有遇到今天他在这里，他是帮我翻成中文，谢谢张浩言。Okay, so in preparing it, it can get complicated if I'm going to speak Chinese or am I going to use Chinese in written language. I did lose a little bit of sleep thinking about the fact that I might have to speak Chinese completely. So I'm very happy to have Mr. Lee here doing a wonderful job to translate.
I think you can do Chinese, I translate back into English for you.
So, this part of the presentation is in written Chinese. I'm going to ask Mr. Lee to read the Chinese and then I will elaborate in English.
好，那么他现在底下很多是中文的，他请我来帮他念一下。好，采访有14个台湾的有机茶农。
So, initially I had the idea of visiting 6 or 7 organic tea farmers and asking them these questions, and it just, the list just continued to grow and I got more excited and it turned out to be 14.
本来计划只拜访6到7个，可是他越来越有兴趣，越来越热情，越来越激动，所以采访了14个。
And in the, as I did this research to collect some of this basic data to have fresh subject matter to talk about, I mostly used video. So I videoed the interviews and I will use that material to continue to promote this event and the organic tea farmers and the whole industry via YouTube and our other platforms, which we will talk about.
那当然了，他每次的采访都会用录影的下来，他也希望把这些影片呢放在 YouTube 上面去做一个推广，在国际行销上就是非常好用了。
So the farmers and the names of the farmers and if they have a brand name are listed here, starting with the northernmost farmers that I had a chance to interview.
那么当然呢，在开始的时候，先从台湾的最北部的有机茶农先开始去采访。
So going down the list, I started in Taipei. There are 2 farmers in Muja and further down. I live in Nantou County, so I know most of the people I know in this industry are in that area. The second one is in Zhenai Township, and his name is Mr. Chen Guangbo.
当然从台北的木栅开始有两个茶园，各位可以看到寒舍跟紫扇。那么 Andy 是住在南投了，所以南投那边他很熟，他继续去找仁爱乡的这个福德茶园。
And continuing south in Nantou County is Nantou County's Mingjian Township, and there were 3 people I visited there. The first one is Chen Mingqing, Mr. Chen, Xie Xianhong, Mr. Xie, and another Mr. Xie, Xie Yuanzai.
南投他又去了民间呢找了陈明清先生、谢贤宏先生、另外一个谢先生、谢元在先生。
Further on down, we go to Nantou Xian Jushanjun or Nantou County Jushan Township or Town, which is where I live, and there were 3 more farmers, Mr. Lin and Mr. Who do we have here? Mr. Huang and Mr. Zhang.
那么 Andy 住在竹山，那么他也在竹山找了3位茶农，那么林哲贤、黄文良，还有另外一位张景炎、浩炎，对不起。
Who is here today, I believe, came all the way up to listen to me, surprisingly. Okay, continuing further south is, right next to Jushan is Lugu Township, a very famous place in the Taiwanese tea industry. And there we have Mr. Lin, a very young, new generation farmer, Ms. Chen, an independent tea farmer and producer, Mr. Lin and Mr. Chen.
鹿谷呢，当然我们都知道非常有名的产茶的这个区域，那么也拜访了这几位特别值得一提的年轻人，像 第一位哈、啊，那个林先生的话，他三十几岁，还有陈淑玲啊等等，还有林清淡。
And finally, in Nantou County's Xin Yi Township,I visited one farmer who I just met doing my homework here, and the second one is a very good friend of mine. First one is Mr. Chen, the second one is Mr. Wu.
那么新义乡他也去了啊，找到了第一位原乡自然富裕茶园的陈崇基先生。那么这个第二位他是非常熟悉的武树水先生，依然茶园。
Connection here. Okay, back one. So, please.
那么这一题就是说，你们什么时候决定要做有机？动机是什么
？This is the first question. When did you decide to go organic, and what was your motivation to do so? I just, for time consideration, I just listed the name of the person and the year that they decided to go organic. So we can just, I think we can just look at the information here. The earliest is the predecessor of Zhang Haoyan, a guy who translated the questions for me. His parents started to go organic in 1994. That's the earliest that I've found to date. And then we have others that are 20 to 25 years ago starting, some of the pioneers in this industry. And then continuing up to just a few years ago. And I believe this is a small, let me take a chance to say that this is a very small representative of the population of organic tea farmers in Taiwan.
好，那么我们可以看到哈，名字跟年份什么时候开始的。那么最早你可以看到在中间第二排中间的张浩岩先生是我们现在在座的这位张先生的父亲，他是1994年的时候就开始了，一直到最近的2011、2010、2014这些，还有2015的。那么要值得一提的就是，这只是一小族群的人，我们在台湾做有机茶农的呢，这个名单是非常多的。
This sampling is really just a matter of who I know already, or some people that I just recently got introduced to. I've been told that there are more than 200 organic tea producers in Taiwan, so I still have a long way to go, and I'm very excited to continue that exploration.
这里头呢，有一些是他已经先认识的，有一些是最近介绍给他认识的。那么据他的了解的话，在台湾的话，有超过200多个这个。有机茶农，所以他觉得还有很长的一段路要去拜访。
Which is a good thing. I'm looking forward to that long road. So then the second part of the question is, what was your motivation? Can you please read that, Mr.?
好，那么第二个问题呢？不，问题的第二个部分是说动机是什么？那这边有八个茶农说不想接触农药。
Okay, so the answer to the question, what was your motivation to go organic? The majority of tea farmers said very simply and briefly, I don't want to touch pesticides. I don't want to be in contact with pesticides or chemical farm products. So that's our primary reason. And it's a simple one, but a very deep one. I know personally that some of these people, their health was harmed by the use of pesticides. Their family's health was harmed. And their land, you know, they had to learn the hard way. Whether it was them or their parents that had to do that research for themselves. They did it and they got over it, and now they are succeeding at organic farming, and that's the silver lining in that cloud.
当然这个理由呢很简单，但是也非常深层的一个理由了哈。那么主要是很多这些农民还有包含他们家人在之前因为用了化学农药的关系健康都受到了一个影响，所以他们是从这个确实的痛苦的当中慢慢学习慢慢改成做有机。
The second reason that was stated, can you please read that?
那么其中有三个呢，他回答说要保护这个环境，还有一个呢就是吃素的概念。
The three farmers responded by saying that they want to protect their environment, to be nice to their land, to make it more sustainable, and together, I think this is paralleled with the idea of vegetarianism. I think the concept of vegetarianism, or this farmer that gave this answer, is speaking from a sense of respect for life in general. So his veganism is about protecting life as an ecosystem.
当然，保护农环境是为了永续发展的关系。吃素当然呢，主要还是要尊重各种的众生， 生命。
And the final one, Mr. Lee.
啊，最后有一个人讲了，为了茶商的需求。
That's not true. There's a couple more, but we'll get to that. Okay, so one farmer said that he went organic because a tea merchant requested it. So that is another inspiring thing. And this happened to be over 10, almost 20 years ago, that a tea buyer and seller in Taiwan encouraged this farmer to go organic.
那这些当然就是为了这个茶商的要求了。其实在十几二十年前的时候呢，有茶商已经在要求是不是可以卖有机茶，你们来种一下，所以他们就为了这个需求。
我说错了，还有几个鸡原因。
好，那么其实后面还有一些回应的哈，有一个他说，这个接父母的有机茶园，
就是我刚提到的张浩源是接他爸妈1994年决定做有机的，他是读了一个研究所，是soil science 土壤科学，所以他去当一个科学家，再回来当茶农。Oh, I
just speak English.
I just did a little crossover
there.
Just
like I say, I want to translate back to English for you.
It happens. Sorry, I forget what language I'm speaking.
That's okay.
Okay, so this answer was that he inherited his mother and father's tea farm, and this is the guy who helped me translate my English questions to the Chinese. He's here today. He went and studied soil science and got a master's degree and got scientific about it, and now he's back on the farm kind of refurbishing the whole operation. Okay, I think we covered about that question, right?
Okay, yeah. Okay. You have another answer?
One more.
Yeah, okay. 还有一个人讲，家中呢有农地，那个环境呢蛮适合种有机。
Okay, and I believe this is the final reason. This farmer is an heir of land on Dongding Mountain in Lugu. So there's a lot of history there. And Dongding Mountain itself in recent decades has faded a lot in terms of the amount of tea production there. The history is there, but not so much the tea production. And their farm was fallow for well over 10 years, and he replanted it about 4 years ago. And this is a very exciting story because he's going to use this to develop not only tea, but reenact the history of this historical location.
这边是这个人他的这个农地在这个鹿谷乡的这个洞顶山这边呢，当时是种了蛮多的茶的，就当是洞顶这个茶了。那么但是后来是因为种种原因的话呢，慢慢的往下这个往下坡走了哈。那么四年之前他们就决定开始呢恢复，然后做这个有机。那慢慢的因为这样的关系，这个洞顶山呢慢慢的又把它富裕起来了。
Thank you.And this next question, please.
接下来这个问题呢，就是问：当你开始做有机的时候，什么是你面对的最大的一个挑战
？So this question is saying, when you first started to go organic, what was your biggest challenges or challenge?
好，那么有八个的茶农，他是回答说，最大的挑战是昆虫害，那么会影响产量跟收入。
So again, the majority of responses were the biggest challenges were pest control. This is a reality. It's the reason that commercial farming exists, in order to ensure that there is a yield to reap. And when you go organic, there often is not. And that's a serious situation. It's sometimes unmanageable. So the amount of produce and, of course, the resulting income is seriously affected.
那我们都知道，因为做有机的话，昆虫害是很大的挑战，因此它的产量就是的良率会降低很多，因此影响到了你的量跟收入。
Thank you. And the next?
下面呢还有其他的原因，没有成功的范例，没有领导。
So, a very inspiring sole proprietor of a tea farm, a woman in Lugu, just decided to go for it and invest in a plot of pre-existing tea and transition it to organic after she had been in the tea industry for many years. And she said that her biggest challenge was that there were no models to follow. There were no leaders. Nobody had done this before. And she couldn't tap into those resources. She had to do it herself.
那这位是讲在鹿谷的一位女性的这个茶农，是多年的茶农，她以前是种这个一般的茶的，那么她要转成有机，她就发现说，哎，怎么没有其他的例子可以来参考呢？没有什么人可以帮她领导指导她。下面呢，这个是还有人讲啊，是有行销问题这种挑战。
The next reason, or that a few people mentioned, is the marketing and the selling of their tea. It was hard to find a distribution channel to the consumer demand was tricky for this product that, you know, they were, most of these people had been conventional farmers and transitioned to organic, and that transition caused difficulty in finding a consumer base.
当然行销的问题就是说呢，因为这个有机的这个茶的这个消费者，他们要的，他们喜好的呢，可能跟一般的是不一样的，所以说这也是造成一个问题，你从传统的农法改成有机农法的话呢，会面对，要面对怎么样的一个新的消费者。
I'll just mention that I see this point as inspirational. It gives me a reason to be here and to find those distribution channels for theseheroes, in my personal opinion. These organic farmers are literally heroes in the industry for facing these challenges.
那因此呢，我们 Andy 呢，就在这中间得到启发，就得到了一个他可以做的一个商机。那么他们认为这些茶农在他的眼里都是无名英雄，那么他愿意来做这个问题的这个解决，就是行销的问题。好，接下来这个答案就是要克服自己的心魔，面临收入的减少，还有心理上的挣扎。
Okay, so this is a very intelligent and wise man, in my opinion. Not far from here, he's in Mucha. He's been through a lot, and that was his response. He's a slightly sarcastic man who's just said, yeah, there were realistic marketing problems, there were income problems, and there were also psychological problems, like what am I doing?
这位茶农是在木栅，哈，在我们这附近不远，这就是他讲的。他呢就说，哎，做了这个收入少了，然后呢，可能消费者也不知道在哪里，行销不知道怎么做，心理上很多挣扎。他心想，我到底在干嘛呢
？Okay, next question.
下一个问题呢，先不要管认证的问题，在市场上你如何区隔你的品牌跟产品
？So, How do you differentiate your brand and your product beyond the certification itself? So the main specialization, of course, is the organic certification and marketing this product as organic. But what else do you do to differentiate your product?
当然这边呢，我们都知道有机的话，认证是最重要的。先有认证，你就能够做你的这个市场的行销。但除了认证之外，还有什么其他的东西可以让你区隔你自己的品牌跟产品跟别的人的不同点呢？那这一个茶，这个茶农就讲，我让我的茶叶自己可以讲话，做法呢跟人家有区隔开，那我专心做我的好茶。
One of the first responses was to let the tea speak for itself and to develop a processing methods that differentiate this.Type of tea, the flavor profiles of the tea, the quality of the tea, and just do a good job. You know, put all I have into making good tea. And this, again, it's a very simple concept. It's also very deep and effective. I think it's really where it's at. I'll try to make it brief, but in my personal perception, the tea production in Taiwan is some of the best in the world, particularly for oolong tea, and that. Offers a large spectrum of differentiation in the actual product. The processing methods can offer many different flavor profiles within the category of oolong tea.
好，那么这个当然就是怎么区隔呢？让你的这个气味，让你的这个滋味要做得非常的跟人家不一样，品质要非常的好。听起来很简单啦，但是呢，它却是一个很深入的，非常的这一个。有特色的一个这样的一个做法。那么 Andy 是讲了，在台湾这边来讲的话，我们这个做这个生产茶叶哈，其实啊，我们这个乌龙茶呢是最好的一个茶叶，在全世界来讲，而它这个跟其他的这个地方生产的乌龙茶有很大的一个区隔，同时加工的方式层次不同，你生产可以各种不同口味的乌龙茶都做得出来。 那下面呢这个问题另外有人回答怎么样区隔你自己呢就是严格控制品质那么东西要做得好那因此集客力就是 集合客人的力量自然就强
Basically the same answer in different wording just to strictly control the production methods to make good quality tea and to use the resources and emphasize them
基本上跟前面一个答案很类似，只是用的字不一样而已。那么基本上就是说，要做很好的生产，品质要好，控制的要好，东西口味要好。
I could talk a long time about production methods and where this is a very a big realm of opportunity, but we have restrictions on time here, so we'll save that for conversations afterwards.
好，那么讲到生产的方法 ，Andy 呢，他其实可以有很多可以谈的，因为我们时间很有限，所以如果有兴趣，我们会后我们再找他聊。下面一个答案呢，做怎么样的区隔？他的答案是说，把它做成一个有历史性的一个地点，就是说有故事性、有历史性，那么可以来有观光客来。
So this one is talking about the he can use his brand to differentiate from the industry in general by using the history of his location and this is the same person I mentioned on Dongding Mountain in Lugu the origin of Dongding Oolong tea there's a lot to offer there Not, along with his tea he can receive guests and bring them on a tour and give them a living experience of the renaissance of this culture
那这个呢当然呢就是说除了你要加强你的品牌的这个形象塑造之外呢另外的话就把你这个地点的历史性的故事呢可以带来做一个导览做一个观光那当然讲这个答案的人就是刚刚 Andy 提到的在这一个鹿谷的乌龙山的洞顶乌龙的这位女士那她呢认为说她可以利用她的地理的这样的一个特色提供除了茶之外的一个观光价值
其实是另外一个鹿谷人，可是都一样的是，可以用他们的家的地来做一个旅游客的目的。好，下一个问题呢？
下一个答案是不用农产品或者是灌溉。
Okay, so here is a farmer that differentiates his brand and product by not using any fertilizers or pest control, including organic methods. So there are a lot of organic farm products on the market that people are using to help. In their whole overall production. He's committed to completely natural farming, including no irrigation. And he's at a low elevation where it gets very hot, but he just has faith in the tea trees that they will be able to be healthy if he lets them grow naturally.
这一位农民呢，可能更为特殊了。他说，当然是不用这个化肥了，一般的传统的肥料。当然，一般其他人做的这个有机的农法，可能他也不去采用。比如说，他不翻地啦，不做其他的这些动作，他专门用所谓的自然农法。换句话说，用大自然的环境自然生出来他的这个茶叶。那他觉得呢，这样的方法，他是认为说跟人家是不一样。
And this particular farmer, I believe, is a real pioneer in the industry, a model that many people in the industry will be able to follow in the future.
这个人呢，他用自然农法，听起来是一个先驱者，就是说，别人都还没有做的，所以将来可能很多人会跟着他用这个方法。下面呢，这个人他讲，他要有一个透明的代表性。透明的代表性应该是
，Right， 我特别用简单的说法。So this is just simply using transparency to represent his product and his brand to show people his farm production, his product, and who he is. Ikocha cooperated with this farmer several years ago in doing a crowdfunding campaign, and it was very effective in terms of. Allowing the foreign or the international communities to get a clear window into the life and the work of organic tea farmers here.
他说一切都要透明化了哈，包含他的农地、他的产品、他这个农民的这个人，还有他的耕作等等。那么 Andy 的 Eco 茶就跟这位农民呢合作了好几年，希望呢用这个方式在国际上能够很透明，让人家能够不但看到茶、买到茶，还看到。背后 它是怎么制作，怎么样生产。那么还有这边的答案是茶树的品种。
So one farmer recently planted an organic tea farm on newly developed land. It wasn't used for farming in the past. And they're differentiating their product and brand by using a special cultivar of tea that is not found anywhere else in my understanding.
What is cultivar?
So it's Hongxin Oolong.
Oh, Hongxin Oolong. 它用的是红心乌龙的品种，所以跟别人都不一样的。再来呢，为了自然农法，茶叶有蜜香。
So in organic tea production, one of the things that's it's kind of complicated, I'll try to describe it very simply. When insects affect the plant reacts, the immune system of the plant reacts by producing certain chemicals that have certain aromatic profiles. And that it can be mostly, most obviously referred to with our Oriental Beauty or Dongfang Meiren, or the newer style of that called concubine oolong tea, where it has a honey fragrance in its profile. So naturally farmed tea naturally has this honey quality to it that differentiates the product from other teas in the market.
那这个人呢，这个呢农民呢，他是用刚刚有讲过那个自然的农法哈，因为他用这样的一个自然的农法，用自然的环境来启动，这个茶叶它本身自己的一个免疫的这个能力，免疫的这样的一个所谓的特质，然后它可以因此而散发出它本身的一个蜜香，从这个茶叶的本身。那这是一个来自于它自然的产生的。
Okay, I gotta move quickly. In my opinion, the source is the most important part of this industry, so I feel okay about spending a lot of time on these questions, but I do have other things to mention, so we'll go a little faster here.
好，我们要快一点哈。那么这个问题就是说，有机生产，茶的生产者近况处境如何？那么当然，除了这个生产者，他要讲一些销售面，所以呢，我们先把生产者给他讲完。
So this question is, what is the current state of affairs for the organic tea industry?
好，那么第一个是靠天吃饭。
This is a real thing. The Chinese says, depend on heaven to eat. So it's basically when you go organic, you're not controlling your production methods to ensure a reliable yield. So you're opening yourself up to possibly not having any yield or having much lower yield and obviously affecting your income.
那靠天吃饭很明显的嘛，哈，天气老天爷赏饭给你吃，你的这个良率就高，否则你良率就低，搞不好什么都没有。Okay， 接下来一个答案，消费者想要买无毒环保的产品。
Okay， so what is the current state of affairs of the organic tea industry?Consumers want to buy chemical-free farm products, so that's a basic factor in supporting this industry.
那这也是支持这个产业的一个动机了哈，消费者来自于消费者的动机。那么接下来说不被认同，大部分 CP 值很低。
Okay, this is an interesting comment. It's saying that the consumers are not fully understanding the implications of organic farming and the cost performance or basically the profit is very low comparatively.
那当然消费者呢可能不太认同说你这个有机怎么会卖得这么贵，所以说有的时候不太认同，因此它的利润也不高。再来呢，消费者需求越来越低，要推广茶的好处。
Okay, this comment is also an inspiration for me personally. It's saying that the consumer demand for tea, not even organic tea, but for tea is getting lower and lower. I think I'm sure he's speaking for the domestic situation here, and we need to promote the quality and the specialty quality of tea.
消费者越需求对茶哈，不只是有机茶，总的来讲。在台湾尤其是对茶的这个需求越来越低，所以呢我们要推广茶的好处。那应该讲起来是年纪很轻的人大概都不太喝茶吧。再来就是需要解决国际有机规格的差别，各国由国内跟进口不同的规格。
我有改那个字，还是在。Okay, so this is saying that we still need to develop the regulations, the international regulations, the discrepancies in the regulations for organic products. And as the Tea Research and Extension Station talked about today, that is in effect. So that's promising.
所以呢，现在讲这个简单讲就是说啊，有机的规格国内跟国际可能是不统一的、不一致的。所以会不一样，这也是造成了一个它最近的一个境况的差别。不过可能要去改善。
Next，
销售不利。
Okay, so it's basically again the marketing is not effective enough. We have to develop marketing.
行销嘛，行销还是做得不够好了。
Next question。
下面呢，对有机茶生产的永续和未来的繁荣而言，什么是需要的作为
？First one。
这个人回答说，消费者需求必须支撑有机产业。
So again, basically, just more we need to educate the consumers so that they will develop an appreciation for this product, and in effect, we will be able to sell it more easily.
这个很容易了解嘛，消费者多多来支持就可以了。接下来，品质及技术呢，有待提升。
We need to continue. Developing our production methods to ensure quality.
就要持续改善生产技术来确保品质。
Next.
下一个呢，说是需要政府的补助。南投世界茶叶博览会。
One farmer said that we need the subsidization from the government in order to develop an industry here. For example, the Nanto Global Tea Expo.
换句话说，让政府多举办一些博览会，茶叶博览会。
These are all farmers' responses.
这都是茶农的这个意思了哈。那么接下来这个茶农说，多了解茶树的品种、做法的区隔。
The same farmer that uses completely natural production methods says that we need to understand the tea cultivars more and to bring them to their potential.
那么这个也是自然农法的那个农民讲的哈，他是说我们必须要多多了解这些茶它本身的一些特质等等，才能够把它的潜力激发出来。
Next，
好，下面我们政府协助外销。
Okay, I got 5 minutes. This is again just a government subsidization to help in the marketing of the tea.
好，由政府来支持了哈。
Next.
再来呢，需要教育了解生命力的农业。
Okay, so we need to use education to understand the meaning of living soil and living farming.
了解这个土壤跟这个农业他们的生命力，这个很重要。
Finally.
最后一个的话，让消费者明白我们能够做品质好的一个有机茶。
We need to, basically, I think organic production had a difficult start. It's come a long way already. So we need to let the consumers know that organic tea producers are indeed making good quality tea now.
那当然要让消费者确实知道我们现在的有机茶的品质确实已经非常好了。
Okay.
好，那么下面这一题呢，你一年的产量多少？乌龙、红茶、绿茶、其他。
This is the volume of yield, so we're just going to go through this quickly. I think I can allow the writing to be the Chinese translation. So these are just the volumes. I did it in Taijing, which is a unit of measurement here in Taiwan, 600 grams. So we're just getting a basic idea of the volume of production here. It's low for the most part. There's only one farmer among all of these on the third bullet point that is producing a significant quantity of tea due to his development of a co-op of farmers. So there's a lot of room for increased production of yield and making more organic tea. So now we're going to move to the market side. I have about 3 minutes to explain all that.
好，我剩下来三分钟，我来讲我的这个行销的部分。
So the brand that I basically started and have cooperated to develop with my partners is EcoCha. And the first thing in relation to the industry, or excuse me, in relation to the foreign consumers, EcoCha exclusively offers Taiwanese tea, nothing else.
EcoCha 呢，纯粹提供台湾的生产的茶给国外的消费者，没有提供其他的。
Along with the tea, we represent the culture, and that is in the Chinese name of our brand called Eco Cha, which is simply a sip of tea.
那么这个是中文哈，一口茶跟它的英文是真的是天作之合哈，哎，它英文叫 Eco， 就是生态的意思。
And I will apologize here for not having more time to go into the methods of our marketing and representation of this industry and culture. So I have to do it very quickly. Mainly, we are an online store, and that is our website there. And in terms of the organic tea industry, currently we are using the coined term eco-farmed teas, since we are not putting certification stickers on our products as of yet.
好，那么它这个啊，它是完全是这个网络商店的形态来经营。那么它还没有放这一个有机的这个标志上去，所以它就把它称之为生态农茶法，农法茶。
So mostly we're just telling the story. It's already here. It's a rich culture. It's a quality line of production. It has some of the best tea in the world. All we need to do is share the story. And one of the ways we do that is by sharing videos, producing videos.
那么丰富的茶文化，丰富的茶品质呢？最好的方法就是用影片。所以在 YouTube 上面有它很多这一方面的影片 ，Facebook 上也一样。
Yeah, so in addition to our website and YouTube, we have social media to help us do that. And Eco Cha also, in relation to the industry here, I personally and the brand that I participated to develop represent the international consumer.
那么他这边当然 Andy 当然是这个外国人嘛，所以他可以在这边代表外国消费者的这样的身份回过来看我们的茶叶。
So I've been doing this for 25 years.
做了25年了。
Focus is on sustainable business practice, and one way we do that is the consumers support the producers.
那么他非常支持永续的这个做法，永续的商业哈，用一个方法就消费者要必须支持生产者。
To encourage the producers to make their product, not the consumers to affect the producers.
那最好不要有消费者影响到生产者，由生产者来自己来决定要生产这样的一个茶叶。
So transparency is one of the basic tenets of our sustainable practice. We show it as it is here, real life. We comprehensively represent it, and I'm being told I'm finished now. So here we are. I've spent my life basically learning about this industry and learning how to represent it, and these are all the ways that we have successively so far. And I'm very happy to have had the chance to be here today. Please, I'll be around and would love to talk to any of you. If you have any questions or comments, please find me and we'll chat. Thank you very much, everyone.
好，谢谢哈，他非常的精彩。如果说有兴趣的话，可以再找他继续这个讨论下去。谢谢。
非常谢谢 Andy 为我们做的分享。Thank you so much.